Hello.
I guess most of you don't know who we are. I'm Max from Canada.
Suti from Thailand.
And we are married couple. Mm-hmm. We met in 2015 in Thailand, and we've been living here. I've been living there ever since because she's always been living in Thailand. We are in the countryside. We have 12 dogs. Looking for Swedish, more like classical music, musical theater style with a temporary touch to it because it's a style that we really enjoy listening to on our free time. So I found a singer. And I don't know how to pronounce her name, so...
Helene Sjöholm.
Helene Sjöholm. The O with the two bar on it make it...
Helene Sjöholm.
I cannot pronounce it. It's Helene Sjöholm. Schloing.
Helene.
Helene.
Helene Sjöholm. Helene Sjöholm.
Helene.
Helene Sjöholm.
Helene Sjöholm. It's so difficult. So anyway... She is a Swedish singer, actress, and musical theater performer. She got famous for the theater play that we're going to react to today, the song from Kristina Fran Duvemala. Play a lot of it, playing in New York, London, also in Finland and in Sweden. For 25 years, Nils has worked with an iron rod to move stone from the field of his farm. One day he slipped and a big rock rolled into him, breaking both his hips and femur. As a cripple, he cannot work and is forced to sell the farm. His oldest son, Khan Oskar, barely of age, convinced Neil to sell the farm to him, and he buys it for 107,000 riksdaler. I'm guessing that it's not a lot, right? So I'm guessing there's a family life involved. I'm not going to read everything because it's impossible to understand everything. This song, Du Masti Finas, which we have subtitled. A year has passed. Kristina was established in the new country. The seventh child died at birth. The doctor said to the couple that Kristina must never become pregnant again. Kristina questioned the existence of God for the first time.
Oh,
it looked very sad, actually. It's a live performance, Minnesota concert, so it's in the U.S. So I'm guessing that this Kristina is the wife of the main character, maybe? I'm not sure. It is. I cannot get through the whole thing. It's going to be too long.
Du fördrev mig, Gud. Från mitt hemland slet jag bort. Här är jag en flykting och en främling. Och det ödet finner jag mig. Men du tog mitt barn. Du tar mig från mig. Kan inte längre se en mening. Vad är det du vill? Vad ska jag tro?
Oh my god, I have goosebumps.
Me too.
It's the voice, but the way that she look and she talk to God, the way that she look, it's like...
angry!
Yes, but it's... she wants to control her tears. It's like an angriness, but a strong woman at the same time.
It's sad.
It gives, it's so goosebumps. Remind me of a singer called Elia Salonga. That has that same thing in her eyes. I'm a big musical theater fan. Wow, even when she did that, her tongue is like... look at her tongue. It's... that must be a technique that I'm not aware of.
Tanken spindlande framför mig gapar av grund. Hela mitt väsen gör uppror och vill säga nej. Kan ni väckt och nu darrar min själ inför svaret att du inte finns till fast jag trodde på dig. Vem skulle hjälpa mig uthärda livet här ute? skulle ge mig den kraften som jag måste få. Vem skulle trösta mig? Jag är så liten på jorden.
Wow, the way that she go from angriness to kind of softness, and it's not just that. Imagine, I'm not religious, but imagine that like you believe in something and you feel betrayed. You feel betrayed.
Sometimes I even think, is that God ever exists? Or it's just me that I am a bad person, that why God never looking at me and listen to me.
Yeah, I guess. It's an eternal question, if God exists, why does he allow... Why you allow that suffering?
Yeah.
I think it's a debate even with Christian people in Canada about that.
But then in the term of like Buddhist way, they're gonna say like, what have you done in your past life? You know,
in this life,
yeah, it's probably like your karma. So you need to
face it.
Whoever took, like for example, today your child died, that your karma, because maybe in the past life,
yeah,
you kill someone or you took away someone's child,
yeah, okay.
Thing like that.
Dear maiden kraften som jag måste få. Vem skulle trösta mig? Jag är så liten på jorden. Om du inte finns till, vad ska jag göra då? Nej, du måste finnas, du måste. Jag lever mitt liv genom dig. Utan dig är jag en spillra och ett mörkt och stormigt hav. Du måste finnas, du måste. Hur kan du då överge mig? Jag vore ingenstans, jag vore ingenting om du inte fanns.
I'm a very visual person. When I look at her face or mouth or expression and she always look at the same spot, it gives me, it's goosebumps. This is the best musical theater actress / performer. It's how music was done long time ago in this black and white movie when the actress was also singing and it was giving the most authentic performance where you could stand up here and your face could tell the whole story and make you focus on the lyrics even more when you can see that the expression of the face is really closely related to what the song is about, and you believe the person or you don't, and she's very believable as it happened to her.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah,
you know?
It's really true. It looked like it's happened to her.
Yeah.
Som skrämmer och plågar mig så. Ordet är om jag bett alla böner i jävels. Om du inte finns till, vad ska jag göra då? Vem skulle känna min ånger och sedan förlåta? Friden i själen, ja, vem skulle skänka mig? Vem skulle så ta emot mig till slut efter döden? Om du inte fanns till, men tog hand om mig sen. Men du måste finnas, du måste. Jag lever mitt liv genom dig. Utan dig är jag en spillra och ett mörkt och stormigt hav.
It's
wow,
unbelievable. Like, I wish that the world was more united. Because in that story, God is like the it's like an enemy in a way, right? Because of what she feel betrayed, but she still find forgiveness in her heart. And I wish that in the world we live in right now, 2023, it was more like this. And I feel like believer, I think we're all guilty of the same kind of selfishness where the anger always end up winning.
Yes.
And her, she's trying to not succumb to her angriness and let the good part like succeed at the end to keep her faith. And I think it's beautiful when it's presented like this, actually. Even though she breathed.
Yeah, look at her face.
It's goosebumps. Even the lady behind her, she's shocked. Unbelievable. I'm born American Swedish. This musical has been the epicenter of my family since my parents first saw it in Minnesota in the 90s. She's not just singing, she lives it. With all the anger and despair, hope, sadness at the same time. Incredible. Yeah, I agree actually. Wow, that person was at the performance. Best musical I've ever seen. I don't speak much Swedish, but I know the story and it was fantastic. Yeah, my favorite part was the facial expression of the woman in the choir standing in the right of Ellen. Yeah, I noticed that. Took me a while to look at the right place. Yeah, even if you don't understand the language, you can feel the passion, of course. Wonderful composition. And you know, when I was listening to that, it's as if she was singing in English, even though it was not English.
Oh, yes. It sounded the same. That.
Yeah.
Never until today.
Yeah.
All of a tremble, I stand on the edge of confusion.
Yeah, she's singing also in English. Interesting. Because people were singing the comment that they preferred the original.
Yeah.
But I think it's true. Every time that I listen to a language or I listen to a movie, I want to listen the original version. That performance was, I feel like it was an iconic part of like a Swedish culture, this song. I feel like it's like you listen to like a legendary performance, like a legendary singer. It was unbelievable.
Yeah.